The pilot project dubbed Integrated Livelihood Support to fishing communities around Lake Victoria will benefit groups of women and youths in rural poor fishing communities in Kalangala, Kalungu, and Masaka districts with the aim of empowering them to diversify their income sources in fishing-related activities. The two-year project, worth $277,000, will also provide training and inputs to help beneficiaries in aquaculture.
So we need to get these people offload the lakes, but providing opportunities for these people, especially taking them into fish farming. So government has a policy, that is what we want to do. And we have started. Even the next budget, you are going to see money voted for aquaculture.
The project comes on the heels of Ministry of Agriculture, Animal Industries and Fisheries recognition of the enormous challenges affecting fishing-dependent communities, especially women and youth, that have remained marginalized and poor with limited sources of income. This is attributed to overfishing, decline in fish stocks, illegal fishing, poor fish handling facilities, and increased post-harvest losses. The Uganda Country Representative Food and Agriculture Organization Antonio Corrido says the project beneficiary communities will be supported to boost their incomes, at the same time reducing pressure on capture fisheries resources.
But also for them to look at these resources as in a sustainable manner. So it is important that as we work with the local communities of youth and women to ensure that we bring to them critical aspect of conservation, but looking at this resource not only for today but for future generation.
District chairpersons welcomed the project but asked government to reopen the closed learning sites.
They have closed about 10 learning sites of Masaka, and yet this project is coming to assist the fishermen on these learning sites. So I see a big contradiction, and I think government or the ministry must harmonize these two positions.
People should really abide with the laws and be able to join hands with the government to protect these natural resources. So if the people are ready to do that, the running sites will be opened.
Fish farmers describe the activity as an expensive venture, especially for starters, where government should put more support.
Feeding the fish, you can reduce on the cost by fertilizing the ponds. And this one would not be very expensive. Otherwise, if you have to really use these commercial feeds, then we need to have support.
Over 1.2 million people are directly dependent on the fisheries subsector as their main source of household income, contributing about 12% and 3% to Uganda's agriculture and national incomes respectively. Bernard Iga, UBC, Masaka.